Today's show is brought to you by that bottle of soy sauce in the back of your fridge since 2008. Face it, dude, you'll never finish it.
KHJ Los Angeles.
Portions of the day's programming are reproduced by means of electrical transcriptions or tape recording.
You're listening to the radio.
That is so stupid.
Comedy is very subjective.
It's one of the reasons that I'm a winner.
All right, you know what day it is?
That's part of my job here as host is to tell you what day of the week it is.
Today is National Pickle Day. Today is National Pickle Day.
I love pickles.
I want pickles.
It's pickles.
It's a pickle, I tell you.
Yep, I love it.
You had me at pickle.
Boom! Big reveal. I'm Pickle Rick!
Happy National Pickle Day.
Showtime. Yeah, it is the Mike Show. So happy you could join us right here. Right now on Radio 434, the Radio 434 apps and Radio434.com. Also on the Alexa.
Hello.
There she is. How do you get our live show
and
our feature channel on Alexa?
Easy.
Really easy. You just enable the skill. You say, Alexa, enable the Radio 434 skill. And she will, and then you can listen to it. You can also get our podcast on the Alexa as well. That's even easier. You just say, Alexa, play the Mike Show VA podcast. And she will. Since the dawn of time, you can, and here's a fun feature. You can skip ahead, or you can go back. You can play next episode. You can just tell Alexa, Alexa, play next episode.
What since the dawn of time? What was that about?
Well, every episode that we've ever produced since the dawn of time is there. And you can keep skipping back and back and back to the original episode. I think we featured Adam and Eve in that one. I'm not exactly sure.
It was a short one.
Yeah, it really was. There was a snake involved.
And an apple.
Yeah,
and the rest, you know.
The rest is history.
You can read it.
Yeah, you can. I can send you a copy.
Really?
Yeah, just send me a self-abused stomped antelope to Radio 434 Lynchburg, and we'll get that out to you.
Yeah.
Mr. Bill Bodine is joining us. He's over there.
Hi, buddy.
Hey. Okay. Frustrations galore.
Oh, good.
Yeah, so we were talking a little bit about this. So the Lexi, okay, who... Lexi is typically my nemesis. Yeah. Yeah.
Lexi
is our Shih Tzu poodle, but I have gone soft on Lexi because I think Lexi is we think Lexi is getting towards like end of life stuff.
Yeah, she's in the checkout lane.
Yeah. However, she has this new diet, and the new diet was kind of sort of working. But she wasn't eating as much, and she wasn't eating as much
well,
as she needs
to.
That's
what a diet is supposed to do.
Well, but okay. she still wasn't taking in as enough nutrients.
It wasn't a weight loss diet. It was a health diet.
Correct.
Okay.
It was to get her to eat something.
Yeah, because she doesn't weigh anything.
Yeah, she refused to eat the dry kibble that they ordinarily had been eating. She just stopped eating.
Yeah.
And she's having, all kinds of digestive issues.
And that's weird because that stuff's delicious.
It really is. I ate it by the bagful. So we got her this new diet, but okay. So the diet consists of something that you have to get a prescription for from the vet.
Yeesh.
And you have to order it directly from the veterinarian.
Yeah, we have a cat on that stuff,
and
or
it's
something like that.
It's like,
I'm rich. You're not.
Shut up. I'm not.
Yeah,
so this is very, very expensive. It's a very expensive endeavor. But she still wasn't eating enough. So the doctor put her on this prescription that cost a buttload.
I'm rich.
You're not.
Shut up. And so that is supposed to help increase her appetite. And did it work? Yes, it did.
Excellent.
So she's eating. She's regained her health. She's still struggling a little bit, but she doesn't look like she's on death's door.
She has a little more vim as well as vigor.
She does, but then she hurt her paw. And so now, we got the diet thing corrected, but she's limping around. Okay. But wait, There's more.
Of course there is.
Okay. So I've gone soft on Lexi, and I'm carrying her down the stairs now because she has a sore paw and she's got so many issues and whatever, yeah. Whatever.
And luckily she's not a Saint Bernard.
Yeah. Luckily. Well, so Tab. Yeah. So Tab, because Lexi's on this special diet,
right?
That Fuzzy can't eat, okay, and it's very expensive, so we don't want Fuzzy to eat it,
right?
Okay, but Tab feels like she's guilty because Lexi's getting this wonderful treat, and Fuzzy's getting nothing.
No okay? guilt. There's no guilt there.
I don't feel any guilt
no.
because he's got the whole kibble bowl to yeah. himself.
Yeah, and he likes it.
But now he's jealous. So mommy went out and got him these cans of wet dog food.
Yeesh.
So that he can have some wet dog food while Lexi's having her special diet.
And what does wet dog food do?
Wet dog food makes wet poops.
Exactly.
Yeah. And so Fuzzy pooed his crate yesterday because she's loading him up on the... And here's the thing. I am of the mindset that if you find something that works...
Right.
Then and their diet is fine and their poops are fine.
Yep.
And they're healthy.
Right.
And they like it. Okay.
Why mess with it?
All that's a dinger... Dinger to me. You and I can agree on this.
Yeah, absolutely.
Right?
Yeah.
Tab and I...
If it ain't broke, don't fix it.
Correct. Well, Tab is also the same person that will move all kinds of things around. Like, things that you would ordinarily use. She'll rearrange the drawers. And if the scissors used to be in this drawer, well, now they're in a basket... underneath this cabinet somewhere, okay?
Mm-hmm.
Just as an example. So it's like a scavenger hunt in my house because she's just like that.
My perception of Tab in this situation and in all situations actually is that she's a really smart, fairly driven person.
Oh, of course she is.
And a certain amount of that behavior...
Yeah.
Has to do, and you know, I'm a clinical psychologist, so I know these things. Has to do with her desire to improve things, keep things moving, stimulate herself, and in those ways. And I think that's a trait of someone who's extremely bright and extremely driven and wants to make things better, like all the time. And she's really great at that.
But that's
the downside.
And she is. And she Marie Kondos the hell out of our house.
Hello.
Yeah. Where, you know, she's like, we have things that I would just be perfectly fine with those things being there for 30 years.
Right.
And she's like, no, I'm going to get rid of this. I'm going to get rid of this. I'm going to replace this. I'm going to move this. I'm going to do this.
Yeah.
And I'm, for the most part, I'm fine with that. But when it comes to the diet of our animals, and she's trying out the new... She tried out... different treats and things that messed with their insides. And you would have thought that, you know, she would have got the hint on that, right?
Yeah.
And no. So she tried different wet food now, this time around, with Fuzzy. And he pooed himself. He pooed the crate. Now he's got dietary issues. And
yeesh.
Yeah. So 3:30, 4 o'clock this morning... I have to get up because Fuzzy is acting like he's gonna literally poo the bed. So I get up. So I'm very, very tired and I'm stumbling around.
Yeah.
I gotta throw my boots on and my coat on and take both the dogs out and I'm walking around downtown taking these dogs out so that they'll finally go. And Fuzzy's just he's just leaving these little nasty wet ploppers everywhere and not getting the whole thing out. It was a whole thing.
That sounds horrific.
Yeah. So I finally get to bed. It's like 5 o'clock in the morning and I am just, I'm beat, but I can't fall asleep because it's 5 o'clock in the morning because usually when we were on FM, this is around the time that I was getting up.
Okay? Right, right. You used to get up super early.
Yeah. I, you know, 4:35 o'clock in the morning is when I'd get up.
Yeah.
So that I could be in and prepped and have everything ready to go by 6 a.m. It had to start 6 a.m. Had to have everything done.
I remember those days.
So I finally fell back to sleep. And I did not wake up till 7:20, which in my world is, you know, and Tab's on the Peloton. She's on the bike already. She's in front of me.
Yeah.
And I sit up in bed and I'm like, why didn't you wake me up? And she's looked.
What?
She's riding the bike.
What?
I said, why didn't you wake me up? And she's, because I'm riding the bike.
What? Get yourself up. Set an alarm.
Like, get some wet food.
Have the poops.
Yeah.
Anyway.
Go out on the sidewalk.
Hi there. It's it is the Mike Show. So
you've had a tough morning.
I did. So we're late getting started, and I apologize to our listeners that usually would like to hear us around 8:30 or so, or 8, or you know maybe earlier.
In the old days we used to start at 7:30.
Well, here's the thing. I am honest to God, thinking of implementing getting back in here by 7 a.m.
Really?
Like a 7 a.m. start.
Well, I'm out
of the show. Well, you can ramble in.
I'll wander in whenever I want.
You can ramble in anytime, but okay. if I'm at least here by 7 a.m.
Yeah.
Okay. I can get all the show prep done. I can get everything done that I'm usually doing on the fly. I can take the little bit of extra time, and we'll be done an hour earlier.
I'm not coming in at 7 because I'm not sure I can stay up that late.
Okay. All right. Here, hold on.
Coffee, that's good for you.
Yeah, it really is. All right. Coming up on today's program, we have... my phone is going off. So does that mean Megan is ready to go and she wants me to send a link? Because we have...
Guests.
We do.
We have remote guests.
Can you email a StreamYard link? Yes, I can. And I will.
Excellent.
All right. So Megan Huffman's going to be joining us from Share Greater Lynchburg. She's going to be joining us via the magic of technology remotely today. We also have, of course, your 5 random facts.
Yay.
We're going to get really smart. Yay. We're going to get really dumb with your stupid criminals in .news. And we've got your top list today. What
do we know what our top list is?
Yeah, it's the top reasons you shouldn't own a pet. Yeah,
we've just discussed this.
Yes, it was. It's definitely disgusting.
Yeah.
So a new study found pets don't actually make us happy, according to this. It's a study out of Michigan State, and we're going to find out why or why not. Well, for me, here's the thing. Jerry the cat absolutely, positively makes me happy.
That's great.
Jerry the cat loves me unconditionally.
Mm-hmm.
But last night, I was getting ready for bed, and Jerry the cat decided he was going to also leave ploppers all over the downstairs.
Jerry.
And he has some digestive issues, and he hacked up something. And then he went around the house and left ploppers.
Oh, no.
Because that's sometimes he does that.
Yeah, I'm aware.
So I was very, very, very upset with Jerry the cat last night. Before I went to bed, I had to clean up after Jerry the cat, which is not what I want to be doing.
My dog and one of my cats, my dog Bagel and one of my cats, Leo, make me pretty happy.
Okay.
The other cat, Toby, not so much.
Well, Lexi and Fuzzy, not so much, especially when they're this much work.
Yeah.
Jerry the cat typically makes me extremely happy.
Good.
And I can tell that there's unconditional love there. So I want to do a deeper dive into this story from the study out of Michigan State.
Okay.
And we'll find out why they say that pets don't actually make us happier.
I think they're wrong.
Yeah, I do too. But we'll get to that. And plus our top list today, top reasons you shouldn't own a pet. That's all on the way. This portion of the broadcast is brought to you in part by Lynchburg Regional Airport. It is so much easier.
Making sure that you never miss that important connection. At Lynchburg Regional Airport, we're ready when you're ready.
Four bags to check in, please.
LYH. From here to there to anywhere. We're ready when you're ready.
Three Roads Brewery is Lynchburg's gathering spot. Enjoy the relaxed open atmosphere of the Lynchburg Tap Room with plenty of space to unwind or outside on their expansive patio with friends and the entire family. Check out Three Roads games, arcade style, darts, and more. And of course, an excellent selection of craft beers brewed on site. Grab a Three Roads today at their Tap Room, 1300 Court Street, downtown Lynchburg, their Tap Room in Farmville, or anywhere they serve great beer. Three Roads is also available at area convenience stores and supermarkets. And if they don't carry Three Roads, ask them to. Brewing Community, Three Roads Brewery.
The YMCA is just a starting line, for the true self blooms only when we find our purpose, what makes us tick below the surface. My why is diversity in unity, a safe space in my community, living with sincerity, giving every day my everything. With my why, I stand strong, seen and supported all along. It's a million faces in a mirror and everyone belongs. Find your why. Learn more at YMCA.org for a better us.
Coming to you live from the Stonecrafter Studios. For custom countertops and cabinetry, shop Stonecrafter's incredible inventory at their Factory Direct Warehouse, 3678 Manita Road, Bedford. Online at stonecraftersva.com.
KHF!
A new study finds that pets don't actually make us happier. Mm-hmm. Yeah, and the study also found that online shopping is just a fad. They also found that pizza is not a delicious go-to food, and Taylor Swift is just a flash in the pan. So pay attention to this one study that says pets don't really bring humans happiness or improve their well-being. Yeah. Oh, and artificial intelligence isn't changing the way we do things.
Yeah, okay. It's the Mike Show. All right, so, Bill, we've got this study, and we talked about this when the show opened.
Yeah.
And it's from Michigan State.
Which is, excuse me, but I don't want to offend any Spartans out there, but Michigan State ain't exactly the University of Michigan, for example.
All right. Anyway, Michigan State found out that having pets might not make us happier. I said, here, wait. Do I have anything with pets?
Well, it depends on the pet, too, doesn't it? I mean,
yes, it most definitely depends.
Some pets make you happy.
On the pet. In my case, now you told me about your kitty cat.
Yeah.
And what's your kitty cat's name?
Leo.
All right. Here, wait. So Jerry. I'm bringing up Jerry the cat.
Bring up Jerry.
Jerry has his own social media.
Oh, yeah. Well, he looks like a rattlesnake in that picture. Yeah. Well, look at Jerry. There's Jerry.
Yeah, just wait. I'll bring up this one, which is,
Not getting ready to bite. He's just yawning,
I caught him mid-yawn.
Yeah, that's a perfect picture.
Right there.
Yeah.
If you go to our social media, it's The Mike Show VA on the Facebook. And
how much does Jerry weigh, do you think?
Well, Jerry's slimmed down just a little bit, but Jerry's a chunk.
Yeah, so is Leo. That's why I'm asking.
And Jerry's a big boy. But Jerry absolutely positively brings me joy, with the exception of last night. I'm scrolling through Jerry's pictures.
He posts some really cool stuff. Yeah. Jerry does.
So Jerry does in fact bring me joy. There's no question. He is a one of a kind kitty cat. The best that I've ever had, quite frankly. And I love him, and he unconditionally loves me. And if you're just thinking, oh no, cats are aloof and they can't possibly and blah 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 blah. No, that is not the case. He honestly will follow me around. He sleeps next to me.
Oh, that's your kitty cat.
There's both of them.
Oh, both of them. Okay,
they're
all curled up.
They're brothers. They're actual brothers.
They're adorable. Your kitty cats are adorable
too.
They
certainly are.
So this study suggests from Michigan State Having pets might not make us any happier. I disagree. You disagree?
I disagree.
Now, early in the pandemic, May of 2020, researchers talked to over 750 people three separate times.
750 grumpy people.
Three separate times to gauge how well they were coping. In general, pet owners said their pets were definitely helping by offering companionship and affection, which is the case with Jerry.
Yeah.
Now, I would go into the studio to do the show, but we did not allow guests to join us in the studio.
Right.
Okay, so that's when we set up this whole video remote system that we're using now, which was a fantastic addition to the way we do things.
And it really worked out well.
It worked out extremely well. But I would go into the studio, I would do the show, and then we had this whole sanitation ritual that we have to spray down all the microphones and doorknobs and everything. And we had this fog machine thing that it wouldn't be harmful to equipment.
Yeah, and Dr. Fauci came in and checked it all out for us.
he did.
When he was here?
Well, yeah, the thing that was most disturbing though is the way he took my temperature. I was not happy about that.
That was I sort of thought that was a little unnecessary.
Yeah, it really was. Yeah. So, I would do the show, and then as soon as the show was done, I would leave. Nobody else was staying in the office.
Right.
We weren't working from the office. And I could have done the show, I guess, from home, but nobody else was using my studio anyway. So I would be in my studio, and Tina would be in the Planet studio.
Yeah. Yeah.
I'm blanking for a second. Sandy would be in the oldie studio, but not until the afternoon. So it all worked out. So we would come in, do the show, sanitize everything, leave, and then I would go back home, and I would work from my office. And Jerry had taken over my office chair. Jerry absolutely positive. Here.
There he is.
Let me show this. I'm going to show this image real quick. Again, if you go to our social media, the Mike Show VA.
There he is.
Oh, this is Jerry sitting at my desk on my office chair.
And daring you to ask him to move.
Yeah. Yeah, so I could not ask him to move.
No.
Because he absolutely positively loves that chair.
Yeah.
So I would just go and slide the chair over a little bit, and I would go and get another chair from the dining room, and I'd sit right next to him. But the whole time I was working, the whole pandemic, every single workday, Jerry was right there next to me, and I'd be petting him, and he'd snuggle up to me while I worked.
And it does make you feel good.
It made me feel great. It makes me feel great
just to talk about it.
So anyway, well, in the end of the study, it found it was a wash. People who didn't have pets were just as happy overall. Quote, people say that pets make them happy, but when we actually measure happiness, it doesn't appear to be the case.
How do you measure happiness?
Exactly. Well, I measure it by
the same thermometer that Dr. Fauci used on you.
I was going to say I measure mine with a yardstick, but...
Never you mind.
Yeah. Their theory is people without pets fill their lives with other interests, and that stuff right there can make them just as happy as a pet would. Now, by the way, worth noting, the lead author of the study was Cruella DeVille.
Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah, there you go. So that brings us to our top list.
Oh, good.
With this new study concluding that pets don't make people happy, especially anyone who can relate to today's list. It's our top list today. Top reasons you shouldn't own a pet.
Okay.
Now, this is not for me because I have a pet. This is not for you because you have a pet.
Well, I have three pets, and they're excellent.
Yeah. Top reasons you out there shouldn't own a pet.
In radio
land. If any of these things apply to you.
Okay.
You can't even keep a cactus alive. Top reasons you shouldn't own a pet. You can see yourself getting high and finishing a can of Fancy Feast. top reasons you shouldn't own a pet. The only thing you use a collar and leash for is your OnlyFans. Top reasons you shouldn't own a pet. You're allergic to cat hair. It's also a sign you shouldn't see Taylor Swift in concert. Top signs, top reasons you should not own a pet. Your kid wants one, and you hate your kid. Top reasons you shouldn't own a pet. You like your throw pillows to be unhumped. Unhumped.
A new word.
Unhumped. Yeah. That's a band name. Yeah. That's a fake band name. Unhumped.
Yeah.
Top reasons you should not own a pet. The last time you went for a walk, Corey Feldman was a movie star. You consider public defecation a character flaw.
When you do it.
When you do it.
Yeah.
Top reasons you shouldn't own a pet. Watching someone lick its genitals launches you into a jealous rage.
Yeah.
And you
only... Was it George Carlin who said, if I could do that, I'd never come out of my room?
Never leave the house.
Yeah.
Top reasons you shouldn't own a pet. You only want one to help you get laid. And it takes a lot more than a puppy to make that happen. So the Mike Show. Oh, man.
What a good list.
Yeah, that was a good list. So, coming up, we're going to get really, really smart with your five random facts.
Great.
We've got not headline news. That is on the way. And, of course, Audio Vault and then our stupid criminals a little bit later on. This portion of the broadcast is brought to you in part by CMA's Honda of Lynchburg.
From brand new to lightly used, CMA's Honda of Lynchburg's got you covered. Shop our growing selection today and find our best deals on our entire inventory. That's savings on every single vehicle. And on our used cars, take 3 days to love it or leave it. Plus, we'll buy your current vehicle, trade in with us, and get an unbeatable offer. Start shopping and saving today. CMA's Honda of Lynchburg. Owners just care more.
Traveling with your family is not only affordable from Lynchburg Regional Airport, it's convenient too. Our daily departures offer easy connections on American Airlines through Charlotte to over 170 nonstop destinations. So check the great round-trip fares currently being offered to your vacation destinations by using flylyh.com today and click Book Now. Prices are subject to change without notice and certain restrictions apply. Advance purchase is required and availability is limited. Low fares, less hassle. Check Lynchburg first.
There's nothing like holding a freshly grilled Jersey Mike's cheesesteak. It's even better than holding a winning $1 million lottery ticket. For starters, Uncle Sam takes half. Then you buy some useless stuff, like a tiny suit of armor for your cat. And before you know it, your sister's cousins and Uncle Frankie come knocking on your door for handouts. Bing, bang, boom, you're back to zero. So if you want to play a winning number, order a number 17 Mike's Famous Philly. Freshly grilled right in front of you. It's a Jersey Mike's thing. A sub above.
Broadcasting from the Stonecrafter Studios. For custom countertops and cabinetry, shop Stonecrafter's incredible inventory at their factory direct warehouse, 3678 Manita Road, Bedford. Online at stonecraftersva.com.
KHF.
This is not headline news. CBS has announced a return date for several of its popular primetime series. Their core audience is excited they lived long enough to see them return. A new study says keeping secrets can be a good thing. The study was conducted by anyone who has ever been married or in a relationship. A woman crocheted for a world record 34 hours and 7 minutes. She could have gone longer, but her cats were starving. And here's a fun fact. Days Inn was named after its founder, Cecil B. Day. Know what the B stands for? Bed bug.
Yikes.
This is not headline news.
No, it's not. It's the Mike Show. There they are, bed bugs. So happy you could join us on this beautiful, beautiful Tuesday. All right. Well, we're going to get to that story about keeping secrets, okay? But first, AAA just put out its annual travel report. Hey, somebody's putting out, right? Anyway, AAA put out its annual travel report for Thanksgiving. That's why I did the turkey sound. Thanksgiving. And it looks like clear roads ahead. No, just kidding. You're screwed. Not in that way. AAA expects 55.4 million people. I said million. 55.4 million. Okay,
How many people are in the country? How pop? Let's just do pop. Population USA. All right, there we go. Okay, 331.9 million. Okay, so 331.9 million. What about the population of Virginia? Virginia, 8.642 million. All right, so just to put it into perspective here, 55.4 million people are traveling for Thanksgiving this year. That's the third most since the year 2000, and 2.3% increase over last year. More than 49 million of those people will drive, 4.7 million will fly, 1.6 million will get where they're going some other way, like buses and trains. It's roughly 2% more cars on the road, 7% more people in the air. So, what are the best days to leave town? Well, unless you're taking off 4 or 5 days early, they all suck. But next Tuesday and Wednesday are going to be the worst overall, and Sunday is the worst day to head home. No matter the day, you might hit less traffic if you leave before 10 a.m. or after 7 p.m. The worst time to drive is between 2 and 6 the day before Thanksgiving. You'll hit 11% more traffic than normal on the road. One piece of good news from the report, gasoline might be a little bit cheaper this time. The national average last Thanksgiving was $3.58. It's currently around $3.35 and trending down. So, by the way, we recommend if you're going to fly, you should check Lynchburg first, and it is so much easier. They're the sponsor of this segment. Let's see, what was the other? Here's the study about keeping secrets. If you know something about someone and you keep it a secret, some people might think that's a burden, but for others, it might make them feel more alive. A new study found that keeping secrets isn't always bad, particularly if it's good news. In those cases, keeping the secret can make people feel more energized and alive. It's still difficult to keep secrets. 76% of people want to tell someone immediately, even if it's good news. But keeping positive secrets can keep people, it can give them a lift. Because rather than worrying about something, they're actually spending the time imagining the exciting moment when the secret is revealed. The researchers decided to focus on positive secrets because most of the existing studies on secrets involved things that were pressured to keep quiet. They argue that this shows secrecy isn't inherently bad for our well-being. The negative effects that people can experience from secrecy are mostly because the secret itself is negative or stressful. Okay. Let's see. Is there one more? Okay. Let's go with this one. There are plenty of times to watch what you eat, but for a lot of people, that starts sometime after the next 6 weeks. There's a survey out on holiday foods that causes constipation for some people. I said causes constipation.
Ask your doctor if your heart is healthy enough for sex.
No, not that.
I may need a kidney transplant.
There we go. And if you're wondering who's thinking about that right now, it was commissioned by a company that makes laxatives. So, yeah. Turkey is number one. 44% of people say it can get them backed up. Pecan pie. How do you say it? Do you say pecan or pecan? I don't know. Pecan, whatever, however you pronounce it. It's second, followed by potatoes, chocolate, pumpkin pie, fudge, sugary candies, stuffing, ham, and rack of lamb. Really? Who's having a rack of lamb? I might want to go there. The top beverages that clog the system include chocolate milk, non-alcoholic eggnog, hot chocolate, espresso, martinis, alcoholic eggnog, and peppermint martinis. Overall, 70% of people say They experience constipation more frequently during the holiday season. That's impressive that many people peg out so much and they still can't identify the culprit. It's the main cause of the problem. Anyway. No comment. No, I'm right as rain. It's, all that food is just fine with me. And actually, this Thanksgiving, now we're going to do the traditional Thanksgiving dinner, okay? We always do. We get the Oakwood dinner.
I'm rich. You're not.
Shut up. It's just, their food is so incredible. So we will actually get the main dinner. We'll get the turkey. We might get the ham, or I might get a ham and do the ham. But then we'll get a mix of their sides, and then I'll make some sides of ours. But we're actually going to be going to Tab's brothers, and he's doing a shrimp boil for Thanksgiving. So I think that's going to be kind of cool. All right, coming up, we have lots of things. We've got sounds, and they need to be placed in a loving home, and we would love to place them in your ear holes. So that's coming up with Audio Vault. This portion of the broadcast is brought to you in part by Lynchburg Regional Airport. It is so much easier.
Whether your adventure is just beginning or you're on your way home, at Lynchburg Regional Airport, we're ready when you're ready.
LYH.
From here to there to anywhere, we're ready when you're ready.
From brand new to lightly used, CMA's Honda of Lynchburg's got you covered. Shop our growing selection today and find our best deals on our entire inventory. That's savings on every single vehicle. And on our used cars, take 3 days to love it or leave it. Plus, we'll buy your current vehicle. Trade in with us and get an unbeatable offer. Start shopping and saving today. CMA's Honda of Lynchburg. Owners just care more.
Three Roads Brewery is Lynchburg's gathering spot. Enjoy the relaxed open atmosphere of the Lynchburg Tap Room with plenty of space to unwind or outside on their expansive patio with friends and the entire family. Check out Three Roads games, arcade style, darts, and more. And of course, an excellent selection of craft beers brewed on site. Grab a Three Roads today at their tap room, 1300 Court Street, downtown Lynchburg, their tap room in Farmville, or anywhere they serve great beer. Three Roads is also available at area convenience stores and supermarkets. And if they don't carry Three Roads, ask them to. Brewing community. Three Roads Brewery.
Coming to you live from the Stonecrafter Studios. For custom countertops and cabinetry, shop Stonecrafter's incredible inventory at their Factory Direct Warehouse, 3678 Manita Road, Bedford. Online at stonecraftersva.com.
KHF!
And now it's time for...
Five!
Random
facts.
Yep, that time of the day we cram your head full of usable information, and you can tell it back wherever the heck you happen to be. Mm-hmm. We don't know where you go or what you do.
Don't care.
And clearly, Bill does not care. But if you say any of these five random facts back, somebody in the room is bound to say...
Wow.
Maybe. All right, here we go. Number one. It's impossible to die in quicksand in the way that's depicted in old movies, which used to show people basically drowning in it.
Why is it impossible to do that?
Well, I'll tell you. According to this, quicksand is denser than the human body, so people and animals can get trapped in it.
It's not denser than some of the people I know.
But while you could be immobilized, you wouldn't get sucked down past your waist. And if you do get stuck, it helps to move around. So like in the movies, they say, don't move, you'll just sink further. No, it helps to move around.
This is such good information, because I often wander into quicksand pits. Have you ever even seen one? I haven't.
I don't even know
where they are.
Every other Tuesday,
you do?
I get sucked into quicksand.
All right.
In some way, shape, or form.
You also get an anvil dropped on your head, I'm sure.
Yes, Wile E. Coyote.
Okay.
Number two, the first U.S. Census in 1790 only had these options for race. Slaves, free white females and males, and all other free people.
Huh.
Yikes. Wow. Number three, the average professional baseball player has 20/12 vision, which is much better than most other people.
Really? The average does?
Yeah, that's what it says. Huh. And obviously, they need to see 90 to 100 mile per hour fastballs too.
Well, and they also need to be able to read the rotation on the pitch to help them determine if it is a fastball or if it's a slider or something else.
Or the yaw.
Yeah.
Tennis. This is number four.
Okay.
Tennis got its name in the 1200s from the old French word tennis, which means receive. People used to shout that before they served.
Huh. They used to shout tennis?
Tennis. Yeah, I did not know that. And then they went, ho, 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 ho.
Sacre bleu.
Sacre bleu. Oh. I can't do the popping sound. And then number five, Chris Rock was reportedly considered for the part of George on Seinfeld. He later said they made the right choice going with Jason Alexander. Can you imagine Chris Rock?
Chris Rock as George?
No, I can't.
He wouldn't be stupid enough.
No, and he would not be, I mean, it would be a totally different character.
It would be a totally different show.
Yeah, it really would have been. Yeah. And those are your five random facts.
So interesting.
Play the outro.
This has been today's edition of...
Yeah. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
Random facts.
Yep. It is the Mike Show. It's the Tuesday edition of the program. So darned happy you could join us, and we thank you for that. Coming up, we are going to get really dumb with your stupid criminals. We've got some good news that we'll share right after that because, I mean, you know, we need that.
We need good news.
Right after that. We've got your audio vault. That's coming up as well. This portion of the broadcast is brought to you in part by Jersey Mike's Subs.
At Jersey Mike's, they slice your order fresh right in front of you. And let me tell you, watching that can send a rush of emotions through a person. Excitement, impatience, baby-like wonder, indecisive, anticipatory chewing, nervous pacing, happy claps, and finally, jealousy, because that's this guy's sub. I should order one. Good idea.
Sliced right in front of you. It's a Jersey Mike's thing. A sub above.
Join us down at the Lynchburg Community Market and experience all that one of the nation's oldest farmers markets has to offer. Grab some lunch from our restaurants and shops, or shop from our awesome selection of artisan, handmade goods in our crafters gallery. Swing by on Saturday to check out our farmers market, where you can shop from the freshest selection of local grown produce, meats, and more. The Lynchburg Community Market, located in downtown Lynchburg on the corner of 12th and Main Street. Open Tuesday through Saturday from 7 to 2 year-round. For more information, follow us on Facebook and Instagram at Lynchburg Community Market.
Lynchburg Regional Airport is going strong. For many years now, Lynchburg's low fares have been among the most competitive in the area, and our conveniently scheduled flights offer easy connections on American Airlines through Charlotte to over 170 nonstop destinations worldwide. So check the great round-trip airfares currently being offered by visiting flylyh.com today and click Book Now. Prices are subject to change without notice and certain restrictions apply. Advance purchases required and availability is limited. Your close and convenient connection, check Lynchburg first.
Broadcasting from the Stonecrafter Studios. For custom countertops and cabinetry shops, Stonecrafter's incredible inventory at their factory direct warehouse, 3678 Manita Road, Bedford. Online at stonecraftersva.com.
KHF.
It is the Mike Show. It's the Tuesday edition of the program. That brings us Megan Huffman from Share Greater Lynch, literally from Share Greater Lynchburg today.
Literally, I am at the Greater Lynchburg Community Foundation, where Share Greater Lynchburg is headquartered.
Yes, and there she is, and I love the background.
We had an awesome former president and CEO that selected this art, and he happens to be, I think, in the studio with you today.
I chose that. I'm very proud of it. I think it looks really cool.
I think it does too. I really, really like it.
And since that is the foundation and Share's world headquarters, it's appropriate.
Yes,
it is our world headquarters. We're
very nice. We're somewhere. We're somewhere.
I think you ended up in South Carolina, but that's okay. That's okay.
I thought she was in South America, but what do I know? I got to get a globe. Anyway, but that's not why you're here, Megan. Each and every Tuesday brings us a guest, and today is no exception. Megan, who is our guest?
Well, much to the dismay of my husband, who can't celebrate Christmas before we celebrate Thanksgiving, a lot of individuals are turning their attention to Christmas and the holiday season right now. I've seen a number of Christmas trees going up around town, and we even have one here in the office. So I get my dose at the work during the day, since I don't have one at home yet. But we have Patty Brown, who is co-president from the Bedford Community Christmas Station, a really incredible organization that the Greater Lynchburg Community Foundation has funded for many years, and that has recently joined the Share Greater Lynchburg platform. So we're super excited Patty's here to tell us about the work that they're doing like elves in Bedford right now.
Well, Patty, welcome to the program, and thank you so much for your time this morning. We really appreciate it. Tell us about the Bedford Community Christmas Station.
Well, I'd first like to start by reading you our mission statement, and this kind of explains what we're all about. Bedford Community Christmas Station is an all-volunteer, community-wide, nonprofit 501c3 organization. We assist low-income families in the Bedford, Virginia community on a seasonal basis by providing a shopping experience characterized by choice and dignity.
Well, that is so cool. The nuts and bolts of it. Let's get into that. We've got a number of families throughout the community that need help, and especially at Christmas time, especially during the holidays. And it can be really devastating for these folks to go without, and kids especially. So tell us how you help them.
Well, since 2006, the reason we named our organization the Bedford Community Christmas Station is because when we first founded the organization in 2006, this was our only program, and it to this day, it continues to be our largest program. We have other programs that I may mention later that we have added to our organization through the years. For Christmas, in October, we screen applicants, and the applicants are, of course, low-income families in Bedford County, and they come during to screenings, and they bring their documentation, and we go through the documentation and look at income levels, and whether or not if they have children, if their children are in school, and so forth. They bring birth certificates and Medicaid cards and so forth, and we go through all of those documents. And then if they meet the criteria, then they are approved to come to our facility on December 5th, 7th, and 11th. And they come in to shop our facility. And something fell in the background. I'm so sorry.
Oh, that's fine. I was going to ask if you had a cat.
No.
That would completely explain everything.
I'm so sorry. Something just fell. Megan, if you could, my Megan, if you could come and adjust the sunlight for me, please. They come during those 3 days during the second week in December. And they receive gift items, clothing items, and food for their family. And again, these families are approved to come in based on their income level, and we assist them. We have volunteers who are there, usually 35 or more volunteers are there each day. Okay. That are more than that, really. And they come in and they assist those folks through the facility to receive their items.
About how many folks, Patty, have you helped? Maybe not since the creation of it, but on any given year.
Yes. So on this year, we will be assisting 265 families.
Wow.
And in those families, there are 425 children and 153 seniors and adults with disabilities.
Wow. And geographically, is it just Bedford County?
It is just Bedford County. Okay. Yes.
Mm-hmm. All right. So you've gone through the process. Are you still interviewing families and folks? Do you take them up to the day that you open up, or how does that work?
Well, we actually have finished their screening process.
Okay.
That ended the very latter part of October.
Okay.
And then our departments, our department heads and co-heads, our facility during this program is divided into departments. There's the clothing departments for children, the household department, the teen gift and toy department. There's a food pantry, and then Christmas Corner. And so all of those department heads and co-heads need to fine-tune their inventories, and then they get their numbers, and at that time they go out to shop for the numbers that they are given from the results of the screenings.
Okay.
So we have to have time once those screenings end to be able to go out and shop and get everything in and marked and everything displayed in the departments. So we can't do that up until the time that we serve, because then that would not give us time to react and get everything set up.
Absolutely. Absolutely. Well, it sounds like a wonderful thing that you guys have been doing. How long have you been doing this again?
We started this program in 2000, well, the organization in 2006.
Okay.
And this is our 18th year for our Christmas program. And we call that Christmas program Christmas Selection Express, CSX. 18th year for that.
Wow.
18th season for that, and the 17th full year that we have been in an organization.
That is fantastic, and it's a true testimony to everything that you guys do to have that longevity in the community, and we salute that.
Hey, Patty.
Yes.
Where all the stuff that you have that you're able to provide for people, where does it come from?
That is a great question. So, several different ways. Number one, donations of goods. We provide lists to folks. We send out a community collection letter to organizations, churches, the schools, and they collect items for us. Monetary donations. You can come into the facility, bring a check, go on our website and donate. There's the donate button there on the website. One of the biggest ways that we earn money to support our programs, and this most especially our Christmas program, is through our fundraising sales. And this is a whole different subject. But real quick, I'll explain. We open our facility, and it is a thrift store, between February and the end of September. And folks in the community, not only just Bedford County, but all over, come to us, and they know they can bring their items when they clean out their attics and garages and closets and so forth. They bring us their items, and then we put them in our facility and sell them to raise money. So once Christmas is over, that whole room is cleared out from what is left after our Christmas program, and it is set up as a thrift store. And we have so many volunteers that help us process donations, as you can imagine.
Yeah.
That is very time consuming going through the donations. So it's like someone donating to another organization, such as Goodwill, someplace like that. Mm-hmm. But they bring it to us, and because our money that we earn, 100% goes to support the programs.
That's fantastic. Do you need more volunteers?
We can always use volunteers. Absolutely, Mike. And we're pretty well set for Christmas. Once again, we think about Christmas real early. Mm-hmm. So we have already called from our volunteer list, and we have scheduled our volunteers to come in during the Christmas program to escort the clients, our families through the facility. We have folks who load cars. We have folks who check those clients in. So we have, during our Christmas program, during those 3 days, on a given day, we'll have about 80 volunteers there.
That's tremendous.
And that's during, 3 days. And a lot of those are different, the first day, and then the second day, different folks, third day, and so forth. Now, we do need volunteers for our fundraising sales, because on Tuesdays and Wednesdays is when we're open year round. And during that fundraising sale time frame, we definitely need volunteers to help. And the way to do that is come into the facility. And the address is 510 Blue Ridge Avenue in Bedford. And just come in on a Tuesday or a Wednesday between 10 o'clock and 4 o'clock, and they can fill out a volunteer form, and then we will give them a call and get them plugged in.
That is fantastic. Well, Patty, thank you so much for taking the time and talking with us about your organization. It's the Bedford Community Christmas Station, and folks, you can learn more by visiting sharegreaterlynchburg.org. You can go onto the platform, learn about the Bedford Community Christmas Station and all the other different programs that they offer, and make a donation. Make a donation of items, make a donation, a monetary donation, and I'm sure these folks will be very, very happy for that.
Yes, we will, Mike. Very, very appreciative.
Absolutely. Megan. You guys have a lot going on this time of the year as well. Let us know. Talk about some of the upcoming events.
Sure. So we're in the midst of our Give Good campaign for Greater Lynchburg Community Foundation and Share Greater Lynchburg. It's a campaign that's running all of November as we march toward Giving Tuesday on November 28th. And we are out at local events doing live remotes. We did one at Boonesboro Shopping Center last Saturday. We have one coming up, Small Business Saturday, at the Lynchburg Community Market. That's on the 25th. And we're also doing Giving Every Tuesday pop-up service opportunities. And so last week we were down at Pierce Street Community Garden and the Whirlwind Johnson Foundation on Pierce Street. Today, at from 3 to 5, we'll be at the Lynchburg Humane Society. We have about 10 volunteers who've signed up to help assist at the Humane Society today. And next week we'll be at the Lynchburg Daily Bread. So these are just service opportunities for our ambassadors and community members to come out. We have 500 different individuals who have been nominated as Give Good ambassadors in our community. You'll see them around town with their purple beanie hats. And we're just highlighting them in different ways and telling their story about why they give good in this community. And that's all intended to inspire giving back from all of our neighbors, and for everyone to find a special way to give back to their community through monetary gifts or gifts of their time or to a wish list. And you can find all that information on sharegreaterlynchburg.org.
Absolutely. And how are things going with the foundation?
Great. Yes. Tomorrow is our deadline for the Youth Philanthropy Council competitive grant. You can see up there at the top of the page, there is a youth philanthropy tab, and all of our grant applications for a $10,000 and a $5,000 grant are due tomorrow to the foundation by 4:30. Those have to be either mailed or turned in person. So I guess the mail option has passed, and you can stop by the foundation anytime before 4:30. A group of 27 local high school students will review those applications, do site visits, and decide where a $10,000 and a $5,000 grant go. We would like to thank the Wells Fargo Wealth Management for the $10,000 grant that makes that program possible. And so this is a really awesome program that we've been able to bring back after COVID took it out for a few years.
Absolutely. Well, you can learn more if you visit LynchburgFoundation.org and learn about the Youth Philanthropy Council and everything else that the Greater Lynchburg Community Foundation does. It's a tremendous organization, and we really appreciate you being part of our community. All right. Well, thank you so much, folks. Thank you, Bill, for sticking around.
Yeah, you bet. Yeah,
absolutely. You can log on to sharegreaterlynchburg.org. Is it 168?
168. We're definitely going to hit 170 in the next few days. So look for that next week.
That's awesome. 170 nonprofit organizations all in one place. You can learn about whatever it is that you would like to give to or volunteer or even opportunities to serve on a board. All that information is compiled on this one website. So start your search there at sharegreaterlynchburg.org. Guys, thank you so much for joining us. We really appreciate it.
Thank you all so much for this opportunity.
Absolutely. It is the Mike Show. It's the Tuesday edition of the program. Coming up a little bit later on, we've got your audio vault. Stay tuned.
Hi, I'm Megan Huffman with Share Greater Lynchburg. Share is an online platform that helps neighbors discover ways to support, serve, or shop for over 150 local area nonprofits all in one place, 365 days a year. You can learn more at sharegreaterlynchburg.org.
If you haven't planned that vacation yet, start by checking Lynchburg Regional Airport with our great round-trip airfares to many popular destinations. Flying from Lynchburg is easy and affordable, offering daily departures on American Airlines to Charlotte with connections to over 170 nonstop destinations worldwide. To check fares and book tickets, visit flylyh.com today and click Book Now. Prices are subject to change without notice and certain restrictions apply. Advanced purchases required and availability is limited. Your close and convenient connection. Check Lynchburg first.
Coming to you live from the Stonecrafter Studios. For custom countertops and cabinetry, shop Stonecrafter's incredible inventory at their Factory Direct Warehouse, 3678 Manita Road, Bedford. Online at stonecraftersva.com.
KHF! All right, open it up. It is your audio vault for today. Our collection of bits and clips and viral audio for your ear holes. I think you'll like it. All right, we were talking about Thanksgiving dinner. Well, want to make it easy on yourself? Target is offering a Thanksgiving dinner for four for only $25. Well, maybe it's not so easy after all.
Thanksgiving's a day for family, but you always spend it in the kitchen. Not anymore. Introducing Target's $25 Thanksgiving meal. With turkey, potatoes, and cranberry sauce, you'll spend less time cooking for loved ones and more time with them. That's right. You'll finally get to listen to Nana rant about immigrants.
I don't know.
Break up fights between the kids over the Nintendo Switch. Get lectured by your niece in college about how this holiday celebrates oppression. Listen to Dad groan while he unbuttons his pants.
Oh, that's better.
And of course, enjoy an electrifying game with the Washington Commanders. The Target $25 Thanksgiving meal. You're not going to buy it now, are you?
No. I'm not. All right. So I think, and I know that I broke my own rule, and Tab, I said Tab has totally broken the rule that I would follow, by the way, and not putting the Christmas decorations up until after Thanksgiving. Okay. You can keep it seasonal. You can do the Halloween thing and then just have seasonal pieces between Halloween and Thanksgiving. And then the day after Thanksgiving, or the weekend after Thanksgiving, because you see, you've got your Thanksgiving, then you got Black Friday. Then, we do have Small Business Saturday, but we're doing a thing in the morning. But then, Saturday and Sunday, and just go nuts and put up the Christmas decorations. I think it's fine. I'm also not a big fan of the Christmas music starting until after Thanksgiving. It's just, I believe in the tradition of Christmas, okay? Then you should believe in the traditional time to start playing the music.
It's too soon for Christmas music. Way too soon for me. There's no snow or mistletoe, and good luck finding a tree. Except the fake ones, they're on sale now at Home Depot. Christmas music was special when it was played round then. I'm excited for Christmas music, but now's way too early to begin.
Yeah. Or what about that idiot that that programmed it in April that one year? You know, April. When they took over my station in April. Idiot. Anyway. Let's go to viral videos. Here's a doctor who posts videos on TikTok. It's gone viral with a public service announcement he recorded at Target. He shows one Christmas decoration after another that should not be put where it doesn't belong. Okay, get that?
So Target already has some of their Christmas decorations out, and I feel like I should stop for a moment as a doctor and give a small PSA. Do not put this where it doesn't belong. Do not put this where it doesn't belong. Do me a favor and don't put this where it doesn't belong. Or this. Or even this little one. I don't care that this is ribbed. Do not put this where it doesn't belong. Not this. Don't even think about it. Not this. Definitely not. You'll get a splinter. Anyways, happy holidays. Stay safe out there. Don't put things where they don't belong. Please. There are things that belong there. Not those.
Uh-huh.
Ask your doctor if your heart is healthy enough for sex.
Yeah, I will. All right. Yeah, most of the ornaments resembled adult toys. Anyway. what is this? Do we want to do this? Oh, it's an edit. Thank God. So, is this the worst Christmas song ever?
'Cause the bus takes each night is always right on time. It's gonna be a very merry Christmas.
Yeah. It's called Daddy's
We're
Home.
Sorry to interrupt this program, but a bulletin has just been handed me.
Oh, no.
There's been a serious accident involving the number 5 bus out of New Haven.
Wow.
The only information we have is that the bus skidded on a patch of ice and slammed into a tree.
Uh-huh.
Stay tuned to this station for further details.
Yeah. And then there's...
Mommy, isn't that the bus?
Good
Daddy
Lord.
Rides
this
each
is
night.
The horrible, most
Put
horrible
your
song.
Mind at ease, my children. Everything's all right.
Yeah.
It's gonna be a very merry Christmas.
Uh-huh.
Ladies and gentlemen,
oh, no.
I've just been handed the latest report involving bus number 5 out of New Haven.
Good Lord.
And from all indications, we're sorry to report that there were no survivors.
No,
oh my
none.
God, this just can't happen. What am I to do?
I don't know.
What have I got left in life to look forward to?
This is the most horrible, horrible.
Who will walk me down the aisle on my wedding day?
Oh my God.
Who's gonna buy me toys?
I don't know.
And take me out to play.
Uh-huh. Oh, wait. Oh, but. What? Why?
Merry Christmas, everybody.
Why is the dad ringing the doorbell
late.
Of his own
it's
home?
Well, don't just stand there. Help me with these presents.
It's gonna be a real fashion Christmas.
Okay, well, no, wait a minute. There's this joyful chorus of them. Not seeming to care that a busload of commuters are dead. An old-fashioned Christmas.
Merry Christmas, Daddy.
Oh, yeah, Merry Christmas, Daddy. Good Lord. That is the worst. I wonder if that's going to get muted. I wonder who owns the rights to that horrible, horrible song. I can't wait for Facebook to send me the report that says that that's been muted. And I want to dig deep and find out who owns the rights to that. Who would claim the rights to that? Anywho, what's this? An Oregon community celebrated Exploding Whale Day to remember a bizarre incident on a Florence beach where a stranded sperm whale was blown up. I mean, literally exploded 53 years ago. The footage of the incident gained major popularity on the internet in recent years, featuring chunks of blubber hitting people and destroying vehicles. Here are people from the community talking about that day.
When it blew up, that was a smell beyond all description. We said, what do you want us to do? Well, they're going to dispose of this whale at the coast. We want you to go down and cover it. I said, really? And they said, they're going to use dynamite. I said, okay, we're going.
Mostly what we focus on is bringing the community in, education, and talking about history a little bit. You know, this is a very historical event. We want to make sure that the whale is remembered.
Uh-huh. Well, here is the original report from 1970 when a small town in Oregon, as we mentioned, blew up a sperm whale carcass on the beach to get rid of it. Famously, the calculations were off, causing people and vehicles to be hit with chunks of whale.
Well, I'm confident that it'll work. The only thing is, we're not sure just exactly how much explosives it'll take to disintegrate this thing so the scavengers, seagulls and crabs and whatnot can clean it up.
Our camera stopped rolling immediately after the blast. The humor of the entire situation suddenly gave way to a run for survival as huge chunks of whale blubber fell everywhere. A parked car over a quarter of a mile from the blast site was the target of one large chunk. The passenger compartment literally smashed. Everyone on the scene was covered with small particles of dead whale.
Small Particles of Dead Whale is a fake band name. Let me see. Oh, that's gonna be today's episode name. Here, wait. Let me. I apologize for derailing the segment, but I have to add this to the list. Let's see. Where are you at? There he is. Okay. Small particles. Of dead whale. There. Officially a fake band name. Let's see. So an Iowa man now has the world record for his pencil collection, featuring 69,255 pencils. Here's Aaron Bartholomew talking about his Guinness World Record.
I knew numbers-wise that I could beat the record. Guinness has pretty strict rules, and so it was really exciting when I found out that everything went through and that had been made official. That was awesome.
Yeah, it's awesome. Amid Christmas tree shortages, some Christmas tree farms have had to cancel a major shipment of popular Fraser Christmas trees. Not Dr. Fraser Crane. While experts cite various factors, there should still be ample options available for holiday trees nationwide. Here is Shamrock Christmas Tree Farm owner Joe Shipman talking about why they'll be closed this season.
A first trailer load of trees would come in. These bins would be full with trees, various sizes, and you can see there are no trees here.
We didn't want to open just partial and have people come in and be disappointed. We felt the right decision was to close the farm this year, let the field get a little bit bigger, give us time to source some trees for next year.
Okay. All right. We wrap up. Oh, wait a minute. Do we want to do sports? Yeah, let's do sports. All right. There was a wild ending to Monday Night Football last night as the Buffalo Bills were leading the Denver Broncos 22-21. With 29 seconds remaining, Buffalo is penalized for pass interference, putting Denver in field goal range. Here's what happened next.
41-yard drive for the win. Lutz, he missed it, but the flag is down.
12 men on defense, 5-yard penalty.
Wow.
Still fourth down.
And this will move the ball inside the 20, and it becomes a 36-yard game-winning field goal attempt by Will Lutz. Good snap, good hold. Kick, perfect. And the Broncos have come to Buffalo, and they're going to leave with a win. 24-22.
There you go. All right, we wrap up Audio Vault with a comedian, and today is no exception. Who are we doing? Ted Alexandro. Talks about how his mom faked Thanksgiving dinner.
I remember last Thanksgiving, I go over to my mom and dad's for traditional Thanksgiving dinner, and my mom orders Boston Market. You believe that? Boston Market. But she served it in her own china. Right? So the guests wouldn't know. But my brothers and sisters and I would drop subtle hints. We'd be like, so mom, do we get two sides with the turkey? Is it two or is it just the cornbread? What's the policy? She was like, just take what you want and pass it. I was like, you know, can I see your manager? Because I really don't like your attitude at all. You know, I've been eating here a long time, right?
All right, that's your audio vault for today. Let's reach over here and please to be grabbing the handle. And give it a tug. There you go. Keep all that sound inside. Coming up, we are going to get so much more stupider with your stupid criminals in .news. This portion of the broadcast is brought to you in part by CMA's Honda of Lynchburg.
From brand new to lightly used, CMA's Honda of Lynchburg's got you covered. Shop our growing selection today and find our best deals on our entire inventory. That's savings on every single vehicle. And on our used cars, take 3 days to love it or leave it. Plus, we'll buy your current vehicle, trade in with us, and get an unbeatable offer. Start shopping and saving today. CMA's Honda of Lynchburg. Owners just care more.
Hi, I'm Matt Bright, the new owner of CRI Digital Impressions. And I'm excited to announce a new chapter in the century-long history of CRI. Mutual Press was founded in 1927, and in 1973, it merged with CRI to become CRI Mutual Press. In 2002, it was renamed CRI Digital Impressions. I also own Bright Images, which has provided print and media services to the area since 1995. Yes, there is a new owner and a new location, but the same commitment to quality and service. In fact, quality and service are the cornerstones of my business philosophy. Quick turns and service with a smile. From business cards to banners and pamphlets to paperback books, we can provide all your printing needs. Call, visit us online, or stop by our location at 3022 Memorial Avenue, Lynchburg. We look forward to serving you.
Three Roads Brewery is Lynchburg's gathering spot. Enjoy the relaxed open atmosphere of the Lynchburg Tap Room with plenty of space to unwind or outside on their expansive patio with friends and the entire family. Check out Three Roads games, arcade style, darts, and more. And of course, an excellent selection of craft beers brewed on site. Grab a Three Roads today at their tap room, 1300 Court Street, downtown Lynchburg, their tap room in Farmville, or anywhere they serve great beer. Three Roads is also available at area convenience stores and supermarkets. And if they don't carry Three Roads, ask them to. Brewing community. Three Roads Brewery.
Broadcasting from the Stonecrafter Studios. For custom countertops and cabinetry, shop Stonecrafter's incredible inventory at their factory direct warehouse, 3678 Manita Road, Bedford. Online at stonecraftersva.com.
KHF. All right. Time once again for stupid criminals in the news. All right. I'm glad I don't live next to this guy, but kudos for creativity, I suppose. A 64-year-old man in Iowa named Doug Kuistra is facing charges for painting his neighbor's plants.
Yeah.
I said painting his neighbor's plants. Uh-huh. He got arrested on Friday. Police say there's security footage of him walking onto the property and applying paint to some of her plants or some of the plants outside. They estimate the plants were worth about $40. It's not clear if he has beef with his neighbors or what, but it's also not the first time that he's vandalized somebody's property in a creative way. Earlier this year, he got arrested 3 times in the span of 6 days. We don't know if it was the same neighbor or not, but back in May, he dismantled someone's porch lights and turned on the spigots outside to flood their yard. Police think he also removed a bunch of flags that were part of a Memorial Day display. Then he trespassed on someone else's property, broke a motion sensor light, and did the water spigot thing again. He's been dealing with multiple charges for all that stuff. Now he's facing additional charges for painting his neighbor's plants, also for trespassing and criminal mischief. There's good news in the world, and we like to share it during this particular segment because there is so much stupidity. A Texas man is being called a hero after risking his life to rescue an injured police officer who had been shot in the leg. It all happened during a shootout triggered by a carjacking. Here's the Good Samaritan John Lally talking about saving the officer.
I just kind of ran over there and I grabbed that guy with the other police officer, and me and him together, we grabbed him by his vest and we dragged him behind the truck, and I kind of tucked him underneath the truck so he wouldn't get shot again.
All right. And then there's this. An Army veteran out of Florida intervened during a carjacking attempt and was able to stop the suspect from escaping after pulling a pregnant woman out of the car. Here is Shane Spicer talking about helping to apprehend the carjacker.
Just getting started with the day, maybe been awake for 20-25 minutes. I live about a mile from that Starbucks. I'm going to get you, buddy. Like, you're not going anywhere now. Like, you cross the line. I feel like if you got, like, the ability to watch out for someone, that you should. Yeah, I would just hope this, that someone would do the same for my family.
And there you go. That is the good news. It is the Mike Show. It's the Tuesday edition of the program. Let's do this. This portion of the broadcast is brought to you in part by the United Way of Central Virginia.
Let's say you're given $1 a week to the United Way of Central Virginia's general fund. What happens after that? Do they take some money off the top for admin fees? No. Your dollar stays the exact same amount from the time they receive it from you until the time they allocate it to any one of their 26 partner agencies. And what does that dollar a week help provide? This is how your dollar makes community change. The United Way of Central Virginia is supported by you.
All right. Well, that is it. That is the program. We are back tomorrow.
Goodbye. Don't come back.
Now we're back tomorrow with another thrilling edition of The Mike Show. Have a great day, everybody.
Thanks for tuning our way. And if you're listening in your car right now, thanks for the ride.
Scotty, beam me up.
We'll see you here again tomorrow.
Who's going to do the dishes?